Once upon a time, not in Hollywood, but inside a lovely San Diego Starbucks, a woman by the name of Amber Lynn Gills was refused service for not wearing a mask. In her complaint in a Facebook post that went viral, she shared a picture of the employee who wouldn't serve her, and she said, "Meet Lennon from Starbucks, who refused to serve me because I'm not wearing a mask. Next time, I'll wait for the cops and bring a medical exemption." Whoa, medical exemption? Okay, I'll get to that in a bit. But her attempt to shame this guy, Lennon, ended up backfiring after a GoFundMe campaign raised over $20,000 from all over the world. Then, this happened even more recently. A woman boarded in an American Airlines flight in Ohio. Apparently, she was argumentative and demanding to be boarded first and was causing a scene. But the biggest thing was that she refused to wear a mask and was therefore kicked off the plane. Social media dubbed her Karen after she claimed to have a medical condition preventing her from wearing a mask. As she exits the plane, the other passengers give her a non-standing ovation. But it's not just these incidents mentioned, as there are multiple people in this country whipping out the get out of face mask free card. See, some people have a hold of these face mask exemption cards, which are completely fake, claiming to give them a pass to not wear a mask because of an underlying health condition. It says, wearing a face mask pauses, either they're trying for a British accent or is written by a third grader. Wearing a face mask poses a mental and or physical risk to me. It then goes on to say, under the Americans with Disability Act, I am not required to disclose my condition to you. Okay, so it also incorrectly names the Americans with Disabilities Act and falsely claims Department of Justice violation. But the card also references the Freedom to Breathe Agency, and this one really takes my breath away. Well, considering that the pons and medulla are the part of the brain that controls breathing, and the pons and the medulla is the deepest core of our brain function, literally the last thing to go when someone is brain dead. Had it not been for this agency though, the most core aspect of our brain function would cease to exist. Thank you, Freedom to Breathe Agency. Of course, everything about this card is fake. So for all these people who falsely claim that they have a medical exemption to wearing a mask, this really irks me for two reasons. One, because they should be wearing a mask. And two, because this is the equivalent of someone parking in a handicapped spot who isn't disabled. But these instances of people claiming medical exemptions for masks, it's really raising the issue, are there any legit medical conditions that could preclude someone from wearing a mask or face covering? Can one truly be medically exempt from wearing one? And just to be clear here, I'm not talking about N95 respirator masks. That's a whole nother conversation. I'm talking about these regular medical masks. Okay, this is a whole another conversation from the N95 respirator. So let's take a look at what the CDC has to say about it. Cloth face coverings should not be placed on young children under the age of 2 years, anyone who has trouble breathing, or is unconscious, incapacitated, or otherwise unable to remove the mask without assistance. I totally get the less than 2 years of age, or if someone is mentally incapacitated. That makes sense because you want someone to have the ability to adjust the mask. Totally makes sense. But the trouble breathing thing, please define trouble breathing, because trouble breathing is impossible to define, really. Someone could feel short of breath, which is subjective, but anyone can say, "I feel short of breath," without actually having trouble breathing. And I have patients who always have trouble breathing and require supplemental oxygen around the clock, and they can still wear a mask. But I'll come back to that in a bit. So we saw the CDC statement, but every state has its own guidelines regarding the wearing of face coverings. In California, the state's Department of Public Health gives mask exemptions to, quote, persons with a medical condition, mental health condition, or disability that prevents wearing a face covering. This includes persons with a medical condition for whom wearing a face covering could obstruct breathing, or who are unconscious, incapacitated, or otherwise unable to remove a face covering without assistance. And in New York City, you don't have to wear a face covering if you, quote, have a health issue that makes you unable to tolerate one. But here's the issue with these policies. They don't list any specific health conditions that would preclude someone from wearing a mask, probably because there really aren't any. The only medical condition that precludes someone from wearing a mask would be hortitis, The term itis is Latin for inflammation, and the term horch, which is fecal material evacuated from the rectum of species Equus caballus. But seriously, there are no medical exemptions from wearing a face mask unless someone has a severe skin condition of their face, like a second or third degree burn. Now, someone might make the same point as this Florida woman recently did when she stood up at a meeting of the Palm Beach County Commissioners and said,
I don't wear a mask for the same reason I don't wear underwear. Things gotta breathe.
And to you, ma'am, I would say, I'm no gynecologist, but I'm pretty sure your doesn't have a set of lungs. Or does it? Because that means not only can it do what it normally does, but can also do this. Which, quite honestly, is amazing if it can do that. And even though carina does rhyme with vagina, that's where the similarities end. But I think the point that she's trying to make is that the mask causes there to be less circulation of air in front of her face. And yeah, this is true. There's less circulation of air right in front of your nostrils and mouth when you're wearing one of these masks or face coverings. But does it actually obstruct airflow into and out of your nostrils and your mouth? Does it obstruct airflow when you inhale? Does it obstruct airflow when you exhale? This is like asking if you go to the beach and you leave the beach with sand in between your toes, is there less sand on the beach? Technically, yeah, but it's negligible. Now, some might say, well, didn't you see the Bill Nye the Science Guy's video on TikTok? And yes, I've seen it.
Greetings, everyone. Bill Nye here.
It's a great video demonstrating how the mask has the ability to effectively block the respiratory droplets from being expelled in a ballistic manner. In that video, depending on the fabric and the thickness of the fabric, the mask impedes airflow through the mask. And that's why the candle was less affected by him blowing. Now, did he give it his all with his blowing effort each and every time? Only Bill can answer that question. Regardless, I think it's a pretty convincing video on mask effectiveness. But here's why it doesn't obstruct airflow in and out of your lungs. It's because air passes freely in the areas around the mask. So as long as the mask is not too tight on your face, and as long as the mask is not too thick, it's not going to obstruct airflow in and out of your lungs. You can actually see when I exhale, the CO2, the carbon dioxide that I exhale, it actually causes my glasses to fog up. That's because some of the air is going up this way between the mask and my face. But also, it's being expelled through the bottom here and also through the sides. So air is escaping the mouth and the nostrils without any difficulty. So if someone is properly wearing a proper mask, they should not get that feeling of suffocation, no matter what underlying medical condition someone has. So it's worth trying different types of masks and/or adjusting the fit of the mask if you feel like it's impacting your breathing. So once again, a mask like the one I'm holding here has essentially zero impact on airflow in and out of your lungs, as long as it's not too snug on your face. And that is part of the purpose of having the wire in these masks, is so that you can conform that around the bridge of your nose to allow for air to flow around the mask. Yes, there are different types of face masks, and some have more fabric than others, but as long as it's not so tight as to compress your nostrils or lips, it's not going to obstruct airflow. All right, so now let's take a look at what happens when I do as many push-ups as I can. That way I'm breathing heavy, where I'm breathing fast and deep. Pay attention to what happens to the mask. Is it sucking air through the mask, and is it pushing out the mask? Let's see.
A few minutes later.
All right, as you can see, I'm pretty out of breath right now. I just did as many push-ups as I could, and not easy for me to talk right now. So normally, tidal volume, where you're breathing in and out, it's about half a liter. Right now, because I just did a bunch of push-ups, my volume's going in and out, or about probably 3 or 4 liters, somewhere on there. You can see as I suck in about 3 to 4 liters and blow out 3 to 4 liters, it does, part of the mask goes in as inhale, part of it goes outward as exhale, but it's pretty minimal. Air is still able to go in and out. So the amount of resistance through the mask is pretty minimal. So you could even try this yourself at home. It's really not gonna affect your breathing. So people, of course, don't normally breathe like that. So it's only when you breathe that heavy and that deep is when you're really gonna see any movement of the mask. But as you could tell, I was still able to breathe. It didn't stop my breathing. I didn't have any harder time breathing with the mask on. It's just very minimal resistance when I was moving air through the mask. The air could still get in and out on the sides and above and below. So as long as the mask is not too snug in your face, you're not gonna have a harder time breathing. And what about if someone has an underlying lung disease? I have patients with very severe COPD, chronic obstructive lung disease. And for all intents and purposes, COPD is synonymous with emphysema. I have patients with COPD so bad that they require supplemental oxygen 24/7, and they're still short of breath practically all the time, yet they're able to wear a mask. In fact, whenever my patients come into the pulmonary clinic, they have to wear a mask, and we always check their oxygen levels, and guess what? Their oxygen levels are not lower with the mask. And medically speaking, I could sit here for hours on end explaining pulmonary physiology and pathophysiology, which would be way over most people's heads. We could talk about how when your diaphragm contracts, it generates a negative pressure within your chest, which causes air to flow into your lungs from your nostrils and your mouth, and how there'll be less airflow if you have airway resistance, which can be caused by multiple things like asthma, COPD, or whatever obstructs your airway. I could sit here and talk about the fraction of inspired oxygen being 21% of air. And if you're at sea level with one atmospheric pressure, which is 760 millimeters mercury, that means the partial pressure of oxygen you inhale is going to be around 150 millimeters mercury. And that means the amount of oxygen in your alveoli will be 150 minus the amount of carbon dioxide in the alveoli, which is, for most people who have healthy lungs, it's going to end up being 100 millimeters of mercury. And most of that oxygen in your alveoli is then going to diffuse into your bloodstream to give you a certain oxygen level. But that's going too deep. So long story short is wearing one of these masks is not going to cause hypoxia, meaning low oxygen levels. It's also not going to cause hypercapnia, meaning elevated carbon dioxide levels. So that's the breathing issue. And it's well established by now that wearing these masks reduces transmission of the disease, and this has been confirmed in several studies. And there are studies that visually demonstrate the difference between wearing masks and not wearing masks, including when someone coughs and sneezes. So check out my video on airborne transmission to see what I'm talking about if you haven't already. And there are countries that have had such low coronavirus numbers like South Korea, Singapore, Vietnam, New Zealand. A big part of their success is because of masks. And just one more point I want to make because I've been asked about this. So what about using a face shield that drops from the forehead to down below the chin? So this mode of protection isn't as tried and true as a face mask, but at least in theory, it should stop the droplets from being dispersed and from landing on someone's face. So it's likely equivalent to one of these masks. So that's all for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you like and subscribe and click on that bell notification if you haven't already. I do have another video coming down the pike pretty soon, which is going to talk about a new N95 that's coming out that's more comfortable and available to the public. So I'm pretty excited for that one. Stay tuned and I'll see you then. Oh yeah, one more thing I almost forgot. I'm starting a new YouTube channel in addition to this channel. So the new one's gonna be called The Mike Hansen Show. And it's not gonna be medical talk like this channel is. It's gonna be more behind the scenes stuff, more stuff about my personal life. Like for example, the first video that's now up is about me adopting a new dog. And he's actually here right now, but he is just laying on the ground. He's tired and he does not want to participate in this video. So go check it out.